works. Then, of course, like it has been already said, we have toilets attached to each of the venues. In all, we have 250 urinals, then we have about 350 toilet seats attached to different halls within the theater. So that's what we have as a
function of the facilities of the National Theater. And we shall be seeing shortly a symbolic handover of the facilities to the Director of CBN and Bankers Committee by the Honorable Minister of Information and Culture, Alhaji Lai Mohammed.
You can see how fortune changes very quickly. From comrade, I've become Alhaji. Less than half an hour. Your Excellency, the Governor of Lagos State, Mr. Babajide Sanwo-Olu. Your Excellency, the Deputy Governor, Dr. Olufemi Hamzat. Honorable Minister of Youth and Sport Development, Mr. Sunday Dare. The Governor of Central Bank and the Chairman of Bankers Committee, Mr. Godwin Omefiala, the Chairman of Committee of Bank CEOs, Mr. Herbert Mugwe, the Permanent Secretary of Ministry of Information and Culture, and the Permanent Secretary, the Ministry of Youth and Sports Development, Mr. Gilbert Abuja, representatives of SANEP here, the special advisors, Mr. President, who are here, the members of the Cabinet of the Lagos State Government, who are present here, and ladies and gentlemen, you will notice that I've been very, very careful in my list of protocol, especially in giving good recognition to the CBN governor, who is also the chairman of the Bankers Committee, and Mr. Herbert Wigwe, who is the chairman of Committee of Bank CEOs. I have my reasons for so doing. One day, a man went to church with his wife. And at a point in time, the Reverend Father asked all widows to stand up for special benediction. This man's wife followed the widows and was very upset. So when she was going, the husband told her, "This is for widows. You are not a widow." He said, "You get money." Today is a historic day in the annals of the creative industry in Nigeria. And I want to start by commending everyone involved in making the day a reality. My gratitude goes to His Excellency, President Muhammadu Buhari, His Excellency, Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu of Lagos State, the Honorable Minister of Youth and Sports, the Central Bank Governor, Mr. Godwin Omefiala, and the Permanent Secretary, Federal Ministry of Information and Culture, Deacon Grace Isugepe, and her counterpart, Mr. in the Ministry of Sports Development, Mr. Gilbert Abuja. May I also commend the entire staff, management, and union of the National Theatre, without whose cooperation we will not be here today. Please permit me to start off by making a clarification. This iconic national theater remains a national heritage and will not be ceded to any person or group, as some have chosen to frame what we are doing here today. What we are here to do is to hand over the National Theatre for restoration and upgrade, and also the 134 hectares of fallow land within the premises to the Central Bank and the Bankers Committee for Development. The Federal Ministry of Information and Culture will continue to hold the keys to the National Theatre on behalf of all Nigerians. The Lagos Creative and Entertainment Center project, a public-private partnership, PPP, has two phases. Phase one is to restore and upgrade the National Theatre to its glory days, while phase two will be the development of the fallow land within the premises of the edifice. Another good news is that this project would not lead to a single job loss. Instead, it will create more. And I think the CBN governor also made the same point. Some 6,000 jobs will be created during the construction phase, where the completed project could generate up to an additional 600 permanent and 2,000 to 3,000 call-on jobs. This is as good as it gets. Before I go into the details of the two phases, let me say here that the project, which has been approved by Mr. President, is a win-win for everyone involved. For over 40 years, no major or meaningful renovation work has been done on the National Theatre, while the adjoining land has been lying fallow. Many attempts to restore the National Theatre have failed, and the government has no money to restore the complex. As you know, this is the hub of the creative industry in Nigeria. The National Theatre was established to encourage the advancement of the performing arts throughout the country, to create opportunities for performing arts of the country, as well as to aid the promotion of social development and the improvement of the quality of life. In its present state, it is not living to its billing. But that has not always been the case. Many here remember that in its 80s, the National Theatre hosted all Nigerian state government functions and performances, including popular musical extravaganzas such as the late Federal Nicola Bokuchi, Roy Ayers, Sky, Shalama, Whispers, Third World, and Dynasty, as well as major state events like Olusegun's adaptation of Dio Fagua's Lamgulo, to provide world-class facilities for Nigeria's creative industry. The new center will comprise hubs for fashion, music, film, and information and technology. These creative clusters will be supported by other facilities, including multi-story parking, to accommodate an additional 1,000 cars. A visitors welcome center, which will house commercial and retail facilities, as well as administration and management offices, among others. Both phases will be connected by a carefully curated soft and hard landscape areas, as well as waterways, providing an excellent semi and outdoor spaces for community use and entertainment, including an amphitheater. It also includes installation of new infrastructure, roads and services, and upgrade of the existing ones. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, this, in short, is why we are here today. Contrary to what naysayers are spinning, no one is hijacking the National Theatre. It remains our national heritage. This public-private partnership is a win-win for all. It restores this iconic edifice to its glory days, which we would have been unable to do on our own, and it develops the land that has been lying fallow for over four decades, creating in turn massive jobs for our teeming youth and providing a go-to spot for our teeming population. I therefore enjoin all of us to give our maximum support to this project so that we can bequeath a befitting national heritage to coming generations. There is a slight adjustment to the program. The ceremonial handing over will now be done after the guided tour of selected facilities of the National Theatre, and that will be done at entrance A.